Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to have a look at applications of rational trigonometry. First, let's start by reviewing the main notions and the main ideas. We start with a triangle A1, A2, A3, and it has three quadrants and three spreads. The quadrants, Q1, for example, is just the area of the square built on that segment. The spread between two lines is what replaces the angle. It's the ratio of an opposite quadrants to a hypotenuse quadrants. It's always a number between 0 and 1. All right, there are five main laws. The first is Pythagoras' theorem, that these two lines are perpendicular precisely when Q1 plus Q2 equals Q3. Next one is the triple quad formula. It's a degenerate case when these three points are collinear. In that case, this relation holds. Q1 plus Q2 minus Q3 all squared equals 4Q1 Q2. And for a general triangle, we also have three more laws: the spread law, the cross law, and the triple spread formula. All right? These three relate quadrants and spreads in a general triangle. So now we're going to use these now to apply them to some real-life applications. So the first problem concerns a flagpole whose height we want to measure. We're standing right here, and with a theodolite, we measure the inclination of this line by measuring a spread. Okay? So usually theodolites measure angles, but we're going to imagine a theodolite that measures spreads. The other thing that we know is the distance between us and the flagpole. It's 50. So in terms of rational trigonometry, the quadrants here is the square of the distance, so it's 50 squared. So the things we know are the 50 squared, the quadrants, and the spread, which we imagine is 0.34, but we want to find this height h, or the quadrants q. So what do? We use the spread law. This spread here divided by q is equal to this spread here divided by this quadrants. What is this spread here? It's 1 minus this spread, because remember the two spreads in a right triangle always add up to 1. So now taking this equation here, we solve for q, get q equals 0.34 over 0.66 times 50 squared. We work that out, we get 1,287.9, roughly. And then to get the height, we take the square root of the quadrants, which is around 35.9. So again, we work with rational trigonometry throughout, and only at the very end do we take a square root to get a traditional height. All right, our second problem concerns a ladder. This is the ladder that opens out. It's a ladder whose height is h normally, and when it's spread out, it's 6 units apart, the base. What would we like to know? We would like to know how high the ladder is when it's spread out, call it h. And we might also want to know the spreads here and here. These two spreads are going to be the same because it's an isosceles triangle by symmetry. So first, let's transform the problem into rational trigonometry language by replacing these distances with quadrants, 64, 64, and 36. And we'll call this quadrants here, this height quadrants, capital H. Now, it's always good to work with a right triangle when we can, and here we have a right triangle right here. So Pythagoras' theorem tells us that this h is 64 minus this quadrants here. So what is this quadrants here if the entire quadrants is 36? It's not half of it, it's a quarter of it, because quadrants is a quadratic quantity. You can think of it another way. If the length here is 6, then length here is 3, and the square of 3 is 9. So either way, that quadrants is 9, and h is 64 minus 9, which is 55. Once we have h, then this spread r is by definition h over 64, which is 55 over 64. So now we know spread r. Now to get the spread s, we can use the triple spread formula, because we know two out of the three spreads of this triangle. Now this is a rather important special case, when the two spreads that we know happen to be equal. It's an important exercise that I want you to do, is to take the triple spread formula and see what happens when the two other spreads are both r. You will see that the quadratic equation that you get has an easy solution, One of them is 0. And the other solution is 4 times r times 1 minus r. This particular quantity plays an important role in rational trigonometry, and the mathematicians amongst you may recognize this as the logistic map, which occurs in chaos theory. In any case, using this formula, inserting this value of r, we get this particular value for s. It's almost a half, telling us that this spread is almost the same as an angle of 45 degrees. Our third problem concerns a kite. It's a symmetrical kite with quadrances 4 and 4 here, quadrances 9 and 9 here, and let's say that we know this spread here is 0.8. And what we'd like to calculate is the quadrants between A and C, and this spread up here. So first of all, in triangle ACD, the cross law says that 9 plus 9 minus Q, all squared, is 4 times 9 times 9 times 1 minus the spread here. So 1 minus 0.8 is 0.2. That's a quadratic equation in Q, which we can rewrite like this, and then we quickly solve it to get Q equals 18 minus 3.6 times root 5. That's a number that's just a little bit more than 9, almost 10, telling us that this is almost an equilateral triangle, which is not surprising because 0.8 is very close to the spread of 3 quarters, which corresponds to 60 degrees. Now we've got this quadrants Q. To get S, we can also use the cross law here. So we have the Q that we've just found, minus 4, all squared, is 4 times this, times 1 minus S. All right, so this simplifies a little bit. It's the S that we're trying to find. So we take that, we square it, we divide by 64, we simplify, and we get S equals 9/8 times root 5 minus 63 over 40. That's the number that's roughly 0.9406. All right, so our last example concerns a line A through A and B and a point C, and we want to calculate the distance from this point C to this line AB. Now I've chosen a line that's on this grid, and this point C is here, 1 over and 1, 2, 3, 4 up. So let's have a look at this triangle ABC. I've copied it down here. The quadrances of this triangle are easy to calculate because of Pythagoras' theorem. So that's quadrants of 13 because it's 3 squared plus 2 squared, for example. So this triangle has quadrants of 13, 17, and 8. We'll let this vertical quadrants here be capital H. That's what we would like to find. And we'll call this spread here at A to be S. The cross law is, in this case, 17 plus 13 minus 8 all squared equals 4 times 17 times 13 times 1 minus S. All right, well, that's simple little calculation. To calculate S, S is 100 over 221. So now what is H? Well, by definition, S is H divided by 17, so H is equal to 17S. There's H 100 over 13. And finally, if we want the actual height, we take the square root of that. So little h, the distance from C to the line, is 10 over square root of 13, which is some number that has a decimal expansion like that. Next video, we're going to look at Archimedes' theorem and Heron's formula, again, from the point of view now of rational trigonometry. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norm Wildberger. Thanks for listening.